Guerrilla Games shared some new Horizon development secrets in the noclip documentary about the game that gives new insights in the development of my favorite game of 2017. So we see some never seen before prototypes, concept art, but also learn about ideas that did not make it into the final game, like multiplayer and huntable tall necks. So I wanted to discuss some of the interesting info from that documentary in this video. If you enjoyed that, then a like would be super appreciated, and let's go. If you haven't checked out the hour-long documentary on Horizon Zero Dawn from Noclip and you are an Horizon Zero Dawn fan, then totally do it. The facing, the interviews with the devs, the never-seen-before prototypes are just really awesome. I will show you some in this video, but totally give the full documentary a watch if you would like. So in 2010, when the studio was almost done with Killzone 3 for the PlayStation 3, they thought about what to do next. Will we be making Killzone games for the next 10 years? And now they wanted to try something else, something more colorful as well. And then when a ton of pitches happened for everyone in the studio, and this is a story you probably heard before if you're interested in the Horizon Zero Dawn development, that one of these pitches was Horizon Zero Dawn, that they already had the girl, the sort of environment, the machines in there as well. But what was new out of this documentary was that the idea for Horizon Zero Dawn was first shelved, because there was something similar happening. Enslaved Odyssey to the West was also revealed, and that was also a world overgrown by nature, a red-headed girl and robots trying to kill you. Now of course we know better, but I can see why they kind of stepped away from Horizon at first. Of course, in the end, this changed, because at E3, the biggest gaming show of the year in June, all the big Sony developers get together in LA after the show, pretty awesome, and here Guerrilla Games pitched what would be their next project. So while they first only wanted to pitch this sort of alternative history, kind of the Order 1886 style of game, they also decided last minute to do Horizon Zero Dawn as well. And the votes before that, so they kind of were like, okay, what pitch did you like the most? And the votes for Horizon Zero Dawn were the strongest. And overall, the people at Guerrilla Games really wanted to make Horizon Zero Dawn, and of course, thank God they did. And now, 6 years later, we know what Horizon Zero Dawn is. But of course, there were some ideas that did not make it into the final game. Stuff that happens always during development. One of the most notable things is co-op. Horizon Zero Dawn had you hunt with a co-op buddy on this blocky looking watcher. Bringing co-op to the game meant though that they had to drop the detail of the game by half, and that was not something they were looking for, that was not something they wanted to make, so they decided to go for a single player game instead. Maybe with the upcoming PlayStation 5, and I mean upcoming, we don't know really when it's going to hit, but the chances are high that Horizon Zero Dawn 2 will land on that platform. Maybe it will be one of the last PS4 titles, but then I think they will port it to the PlayStation 5 as well. Maybe then they will revisit this idea of having a co-op buddy to hunt with. I would be down for that, of course. But looking at the way that Horizon Zero Dawn was treated really as a narrative focused game, I really think that the sequel will follow in the same steps. But maybe, just like they did with Uncharted, they will have a separate co-op mode where, yeah, it doesn't really matter that the detail will be in half or something like that. I really hope they try and do something like that, even an arena where you can co-op hunt with a buddy. I mean, it's interesting that they thought about Horizon Zero Dawn as a co-op game at first. I did not know this, so I really think there's hope for multiplayer in a future title. Also really cool is the new concept art that I never saw before that was used in the documentary. This one of the robot guy on what looks like some sort of Killzone Shadow Vault type droid Stormbird. And Guerrilla Games of course mentioned that they came from some sort of military robots in Killzone to this new game. So they first had all these military machines and then later decided to go more to robot animals, robot dinosaurs. Those, like, had some sort of emotional impact when you hunted them, and I really agree with that. It's really awesome to see that sort of evolution. But here we do see this guy flying on this robot, flying on this potentially early Stormbird concept art. Really awesome stuff. Of course, something we would all love to see, fly on the back of a machine. Then if we go and look at the background, we see of course an early concept art of Meridian. And during this part of the documentary, it was noted that they decided to make the world 50 times smaller than they first envisioned. Showing you again how much things changed. I mean, the world is already pretty big right now. Imagine it 50 times larger, man. Also, Meridian wasn't called Meridian at first. Here we see an early concept of that city called Mesa City. This really makes me think of some sort of RuneScape kind of style. It's almost four times as big was the city at first, but we also see machines here in the city, something we of course don't see anymore, to make Aloy special. She's the only one that can interact with these machines on such level, she can hack them, and that's why they also changed the horse that Aloy is sitting on, because Aloy should be special, the only girl that would ride these machines thanks to her focus device. So they removed horses from the game completely, something that a lot of people at Guerrilla Games were used to, and in the end let Aloy ride machines. And if you look at it from that way, you really think, okay, riding machines is way more cooler. So it's really cool how a fresh mind that came later to the studio, John Gonzalez, that is the narrative director, changed so much, but in the end it was totally for the best. Another thing I wanted to touch on that was discussed in the documentary was an idea they first had for components of the machines that you would not just leave on the ground after you kill them, and it was of course too much for Aloy to carry a thunder jaw to a camp. So the game director Matthijs de Jonge explains it that you would shoot a flare into the sky, then a nearby tribe would come on some sort of flying pirate ship to take all the parts, bring it to the nearby city where you could get the resources, or they would just drop some coins down. But this is just another example of ideas becoming too big and too complicated. I mean, I also think that this would be cool for the first time and the second time, but it would really slow the gameplay down if every time you kill a big machine, you had to wait for this flying ship to arrive to get the goods. But I still thought it was an interesting idea nevertheless, just like huntable tall necks. Also something that was first in the game, huntable tall necks. We saw them at E3 2016 like walking in herds, so implying that we might be able to kill them. This famous artwork is there as well. This was of course leaked before the game was revealed. But yeah, that was first the case. They were huntable, but it was later changed because some of the team did not feel that hunting these harmless creatures was something Aloy would do. And I totally agree with that. Of course, I still hope that there would be an evil mind in the second game or something that would hack these tall necks to make them corrupted, so we would have to fight them, because really I don't know how we can take out those guys, but I would love to try, and I really think this could create an awesome set piece. Again, the documentary is an awesome watch, way more insights and behind the scenes early footage of the game, like a fight against a blocky Thunderjaw. I put a link to the documentary in the description down below, so totally check it out if you got the time. Subscribe for everything Horizon Zero Dawn. Like I said in my previous Horizon Zero Dawn videos, it will be quiet in terms of news for sure, but when we know more about the game or anything sequel related, I'll be the first to tell you, so of course subscribe to stay up to date on that. Like this video to support the channel, check out my video on God of War with a ton of new info we got. Thanks a lot for watching, I will speak to you next time, and goodbye.